Hey people, welcome back. This is Shweta. Today I will be talking about a beautiful traditional embroidery from Punjab known as Fulkari. Fulkari is a traditional folk embroidery of Punjab. Ful means flower and kari means work. The meaning of Fulkari is floral work. It is also known as Gulkari, an intricate needlework. The Fulkari is more than an embroidery, a ritualistic tradition of Sikh heritage. It was also shared with Hindus and Muslims. Fulkari has been mentioned in the famous Punjabi folklore of Heer Rancha, a love tale. There are mainly two types of Fulkari embroidery. They are number 1, Bhag, which means garden or flower, and number 2, Chop, which is usually embroidered on borders. Stitches used in Fulkari embroidery. The most commonly used stitches are darning stitch and satin stitch in Fulkari, and to the border, the fabric stitches like herringbone stitch, running stitch, holbein stitch or buttonhole stitch are used. Motifs used in Fulkari embroidery. The motia, which means jasmine flower, surajmukhi, which means sunflower, genda, which means marigold, kamal, meaning lotus plant, karela, meaning bitter gourd, gobi, which means cauliflower, dhania, meaning coriander, kanki, which means wheat, mirchi, which means chili, leheria bag, meaning wave, and more, which means peacock. Fabrics used in Fulkari embroidery. Plain cotton fabric known as khatar is used. Threads used in Fulkari. Untwisted floss silk yarns known as pat are used in Fulkari. Nowadays they are also using silk threads in Fulkari embroidery. Colors used in Fulkari. Bright colors like red, white, golden, green, blue, purple and orange. Fulkari plays a very important role throughout a girl's life. When a baby girl is born, her grandmother will start creating the future bride's wedding attire, which is owned by the bride on her wedding day. Also, when a woman gives birth to a boy, she is given a Fulkari, which is owned by her when she goes out for the first time after delivery. And when a lady dies, her body is covered with Fulkari.